If you're watching this video today, I know you have an interest in learning one programming language or the other, but maybe you're confused. So I'm going to talk about the five programming languages to learn in 2019 to get a job. I'm going to include the salary pay ranges so that you get to know how much to expect to earn if you want to work for a company, but this is not a freelance amount you could earn. So there are so many languages out there like Swift, Python, PHP, JavaScript, Java, Go. Oh, there's so many of them. But in this video, we're going to break it down. And maybe at the end, you'll be able to narrow down and choose what to do. But one thing you need to know is that you need to know what problem you want to solve with the programming language you're going to learn. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you get to know when I publish new videos. And learn what I share on this channel, which is self-development and how to make money online. It is okay to be confused to choose one language to learn or the other because there are so many articles and videos on the internet that makes it very confusing. But my number five language to learn is PHP. PHP is still very relevant for making websites and web applications. Facebook and WordPress still uses PHP, and the WordPress websites and blogs out there still need awesome plugins to make the website work greatly. So if this is one for you, go for it. The pay range is from low 47k to 156k depending on your skill. So number four is Java. I put Java and Kotlin because Google brought in a new language called Kotlin, which is going to replace Java for making Android mobile apps. So if you want to be making mobile apps for Android phones, then you learn Java. It is very unique and it's been around for a while. The pay range for Java is between 60k for low skill to 170k for high experienced person. Number three is Swift. Swift or Objective-C, because Swift is newer than Objective-C, I would prefer you learn Swift because it's used for making iOS apps, and these apps are really great because you could make most of the apps on iOS you need to pay, unlike an Android. So the Swift developers and a little bit higher than Android developers, but it doesn't mean that you cannot be a freelancer with your skill. You can still make a lot of money as a freelancer with your Swift skills. The salary range is for low skilled is 78k and for high skilled is 165k. Number two is JavaScript. I love JavaScript. It is easy to learn. There are tons of free resources to learn. But for you to stand out as a JavaScript developer, you have to know HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and other libraries like jQuery, Vue, React, AngularJ or Node.js, so that you'll be able to stand out from the pack. If everyone knows how to do JavaScript and HTML and CSS, then there'll be so much competition. But if you go ahead and learn a little bit more, maybe get to know the algorithms a lot more, then you stand a better chance. For low skill, you earn 60K. And if you have high experience, 153K. My number one language to learn is Python. Python is great. I love it. In this age of artificial intelligence, Python is the number one language for writing artificial intelligence models, for machine learning. I love Python. It can do so many things. Python is a great language for writing. You can use it to do web development with the Django library and Flask. You can use it for data analytics. You can use it to make games. You can use it to automate boring tasks if you have boring tasks at work that you want to remove the human error or reduce the time you spend in sorting out unnecessary stuff. You can use Python to write a script to automate your everyday tasks, which is, there's a course called Automate the Boring Stuff with Python. You could also use Python to do web scraping or network programming for my network engineers. So Python pay range is between 42K and 161K for high experienced Python programmers. One thing good is that Python is very easy to learn because it is written in a language that is like English language. Imagine when you want to write hello world in Python. This is just the way it goes. Print and hello world. But if you want to write hello world in, let's say, Java or Go language, then it's a little bit more daunting. So that's why I love using Python. This is a code for writing just hello world in Java. You have to write all this code for you to be able to print hello world in Java. And this is a code for writing hello world in Go language. So I pulled this out from a tutorial, interactive tutorial page. This is another one for writing JavaScript. So you understand why I say that Python is very easy to learn. And many companies and many products that you use today use Python. YouTube, SurveyMonkey, Instagram, Pinterest, they were all built with Python. So you see how great this language is. That's my number one language to learn. Other languages you might consider to learn in 2019 is Go. Go is growing so fast. So many companies in Silicon Valley are using Go. It's a language developed by Google to be able to make it easy to write software for different things. And Go is great. It's so many companies haven't really adopted it. Google, Facebook, Netflix, they use Go. The next language you should consider is R. R is very good for data analytics. You could write machine learning models using R and plot your charts. One good thing is that you have to write less code in R. I've actually compared code on Python and R, so you write less number of codes with R. The pay range is between 42K and 180K. Wrapping it all up, number five language for you to learn is PHP. My number four is Java or Kotlin, but go for Java. Number three is Swift. Learn Swift for your iOS, JavaScript for web development. And my number one is Python. Thank you. And I hope this video brings value to you and you make your choice. Subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell, and please always check back for new videos, or you check my website, mysetnuggets.com, for more value. Check the description box below for the links to where you can learn all this. Thank you.